The full general proof of the divergence theorem is quite difficult. So in this video, we will give the main ideas of the proof if the region and surface are nice enough. And then it's actually not that difficult, as you'll see in this video. So we will have our solid E over here, and a projection on the xy plane, we will call that D. We have some vector fields, capital F. We say, well, the lower part of our surface will be parameterized by some u1 of x and y, the upper part by some u2 of x and y. So those are the names. And then we will show that the triple integral of the vector field across the boundary, so the flux, equals the triple integral of the divergence of capital F. So what do we do? Well, first we write down F in its components, P, Q, and R. And then we will write down what the triple integral is of the divergence of F. That's the triple integral of Px plus Qi plus Rz. And then we will write down what actually the double integral is of the vector field, so what the flux is. So for that we also use F equals P plus Q plus R in the different directions. So that gives you, by definition, this integral, if you write down what the surface integral becomes. And now we have to prove that this integral over here equals this integral over here. And what do? You show that this term equals this term, that this term equals that term, and this term equals that term. And in this video we'll only do the last one. The other two go the same way. So we only will show this equality. Now, how do we do that? Well, first we are going to work with this part. We rewrite this part first. So the left-hand side. So how can we compute that? Only do the z integral, so this triple integral, if we perform the integration with respect to z first, then z goes from u1 to u2, over here, of the rdz with respect to z, and then the other integrals will be an integral along d, this one with respect to the area element. Now, what do we have to do? We have to differentiate r with respect to z and then integrate, so that cancels out. So we get r in the upper boundary minus r in the lower boundary, so that's the z integral, and we just leave the other integrals. So we will rewrite now this right hand side over here in the same way. So how are we going to do that? We have to parameterize all six sides of our solid, say the surface of the sides, with the surface down and the surface up. And then we notice that along the sides, the normal, the component of the normal in the z direction is zero, so they won't give a contribution. And we notice that if we are up or down, we can parameterize our surface, for example, our surface up, using the coordinates x and y, and then u2 of x and y. Or if we are down, we can parameterize the lower surface as x, y, u1 of x and y. So r down and up can be parameterized like this. Now then we use this parameterization, for example, on the upper part to compute the normal. That's standard, so the normal becomes minus u2 differentiated with respect to x, minus u2 differentiated with respect to y, plus k. Now, if we take the inner product with n, which we need over here, we see that we just get 1, because those two terms cancel out. So the integral along the upper part of r times k and n becomes, if we parameterize using x and y, integral along d, r of x and y, and for z we are on the upper surface for z. So we have u2 of x and y, and this vector k in n equals 1. So that's the flux integral along the upper surface. Along the lower surface we can do it exactly the same way. Just pay attention, the normal is now pointing in the downwards direction, so you get an additional minus sign. So if you combine those two, upper and lower, and the sides, integral along the sides is 0, so your total integral along S becomes the upper one minus the lower one. And as you see, these two are exactly the same. So that's why this part equals that part. You can do the other two parts similarly. And that shows you why the divergence theorem holds in this easier case.